So what makes the team special? Probably the turquoise now. That must make it pretty special.
Few brands are as synonymous with racing as Yeti, especially when you're talking about enduro. Yeti's race-winning culture spans all the way from bike development to the Yeti Fox Factory racing team, producing some of the sport's most decorated riders.
Name's Damian Smith. I've been working with the Yeti Fox development team since the beginning. Starting to dive into their history and realizing, wow, they're so rooted in racing. That's what this company is, and that's kind of honestly what made me fall in love with the company.
That's always been the thing with Yeti, is like everyone at the factory keeps tabs of like what's going on at the races, and everyone there is super passionate about riding, and you feel that. There's such a vibe at the factory of like everything's, you know, towards the race team. So everyone's wanting to see the team do well and everything be successful, and that environment is just unmatched.
All that passion has yielded stacks of trophies and showers of champagne, but it does pile on the pressure. How do you maintain momentum race after race and year after year?
Even to this day, that's a huge thing that weighs on my shoulder, is like the legacy of winning and finding the next up-and-coming rider and the talent, and just carrying that into this decade.
Yeti has a talent for finding talent, raising winners like Giovi, Graves, and Gwynn. Not to mention one particular multi-time world champion and current overall EDR leader.
Richie Reard, 28. I've been with Yeti factory team since 2011, so 12 years now. Yeah, with Yeti, it's been me, Damien, Sean, and Jared for 12 years, I guess. And just having that bit of heritage, and I guess having a bit of an equation that works for us. And yeah, and in the last few years, we've kind of built out our program more and more, it seems like. And yeah, it's just been great.
My name is Slavik Lukasik.
I'm Bex Barona.
My name is JT Fisher, and I just turned 19. I started riding for Yeti in January, so this is my first season on the team. I feel like being a part of the team has like been something that's like super motivating for me to like go train harder, and like really, like I really want to like prove myself to everyone and like show that I'm like, I belong here.
Yeti isn't just focused on today's win. Polishing raw gems is nearly as important as, say, Richie's hunt for the 2023 overall. Any rider who joins this family plugs into a deep racing pedigree and thus has access to some seriously good racing knowledge.
For a rider that comes through a program, it's a known thing that you're gonna get helped, and you're also helping the next person.
There's so many just legendary people on the team. Like it's crazy, it's like a huge learning experience.
My main focus is with the factory team and all that, just helping them to win races and win titles. But obviously, you know, you've got to look out for the next generation, because these guys aren't going to be around forever, so you've always got to look out for the young kids. And when you help them out with something and then they apply that to their racing, then seeing them, you know, pull off a good result, if that's really rewarding. So they love that side of it.
The formula here isn't set in stone, though. Every rider's different, and Yeti's blueprint generates success by building on individual strengths.
I think, you know, every rider is a unique person, and what they bring to the program is pretty exciting. And what Bex brought to the program, just the relationship, you know, with Jared and her, I think is a lot more than, you know, I expected.
We're very different people, me and Jared. It took us a while to realise that I go about my racing a little bit different to Jared, but off the bike we're quite similar, just mess around and quite like to have a joke and stuff.
I've got sheep shit on my hand just to add to the carnage.
But it's cool because you can just pick up like tips from, like, even if someone goes about their racing in a totally different way, like a bit more like rigid with their plans and their training strategies and stuff. It's like I've definitely picked up a lot of tips, but I've just sort of formed them into the way that Bex does it. It's worked quite well.
All these pieces together, Yeti's racing genetics, keen eyes for talent, and an expectation of mentorship from one champion to the next, are what have made turquoise synonymous with mountain bike racing.
The reason why this team's so special is because everybody has a general sense and urgency, expectation of winning. And it doesn't need to be said, it's just, that's what everybody wants, is the best.